It's like they found the answer they've been waiting for. In a mandatory piece of law ushering 1984, quelling opposition by emphasizing on a religion to imprison all types of political dissent, which is how the vague definition of extremism serves to catch all of us in its net, of monitoring and spy cops by those who have sold a soul for power via implementing a form of social control that challenges normative beliefs. These guys are government-sanctioned thought police, former extremists, now terrorism experts, who, for some on the face of it, don't seem to be that well-versed when it comes to preserving security. Call that an educated guess, since their advice is given behind closed doors. But what we do know, thanks to Spinwatch, is that prevent evolved from the Cold War with updated methods that should be forgotten, like rebranding Muslims as the new fifth column, to be watched under a microscope, forcing us to self-censor in our own private space now that surveillance technology oversaturates the marketplace, fostering an atmosphere where even our kids are seen as enemies of the state, while trying not to compound this feeling of being disempowered and dispossessed. Prevent interventions may be quick to stress that safeguarding is what this is all about, but forgive me if that doesn't shred my ray of doubt. Judging this by all the ideologies as leaving out has given me a different perspective. Shining a light on this objective will make it plain to see that there are certain extremes prevent will never deal with or give the third degree intentionally, even if their officers agree with us. It'll never be anything more than just verbal. A hardcore Zionist being a channel referral for his Zionism isn't gonna happen, since British citizens can go join the IDF without being challenged when it comes to violating international human rights. The green light is given to Israeli colonialism and apartheid. So again, forgive me if I'm not amused with your approach in dealing with those from other religions and far right. Although confronting them is still very important, hypocrisy is also why prevent is seen as a kind of insurance, buying up native informants while residing in the architecture of state secrecy, something that's completely opposed by students, not suspects, whose tour recently opened a lot of eyes to the fact that no matter how many people your interventions guide, you need to recognize that your referral process is also wrecking lives, a process fully endorsed by a policy that discriminates. Because your main focus is the Islamist problem. Yet regarding the real causes of terrorism, prevent's not designed to solve them. Its role is conflict management, here to maintain the status quo. So come to think of it, it's like an upgraded form of quintal probe to erode our civil liberties for the elite to strengthen neoliberalism religiously. Never mind the carnage that they've caused or the life they've cut short. In this never-ending war, we'll repeal this mandatory piece of law, ushering 1984.